After implementation of a statewide telepsychiatry network, wait times have been cut from 4 days down to about 10 hours. The cost have been cut by almost two-thirds. What do you see as the future of telemedicine, particularly to address access issues? What barriers can we anticipate as well?
Telemedicine is one of those exciting innovations that will, I believe, allow for individuals, especially in rural and underserved areas, access to that intellectual capital and resources from a clinical standpoint to make decisions on patients that are before them without being able to save resources and save patients in so many ways. We in the state of Georgia have a stroke program that's kind of a spoke and wheel program, where at the Medical College of Georgia there's a neurologist that works with telemedicine and has a network of clinics and hospitals around the state, where if somebody comes in with symptoms of a stroke, that physician is able to literally see that patient in real time and determine, one, whether or not they need medication, whether or not they're having a stroke, whether they can be treated in the community, or whether they have to be transferred to the academic center. In the past, it was a call on the ground, no ability to be able to talk with somebody who might have greater resources or knowledge, and all of those patients tried to get to the academic center. Huge waste of money and not having patients at the center of that decision. So telemedicine is absolutely vital, and I think we need to accentuate the ability to use telemedicine. As you well know right now, oftentimes telemedicine, telehealth, is not paid for. It's not compensated. So people eat those, the clinicians eat those costs, they assume those costs that help the patient, yes, but make it so it's much more difficult for them to be able to provide the quality care necessary.
Thank you.